Right, Scott Hudson, Mike today, gentlemen, I thank you very much. Here on Saturday night, my guest at this time, Bam Bam Bigelow, a man that we're going to be seeing later on in this program in action. But what about Monday night? I don't know if you've sorted things out in front of a national television audience on WCW Monday Nitro. Goldberg comes out and says, Bigelow, Bam Bam, you're next. You've got him at Super Brawl on Sunday the 21st. On that big mega event on pay-per-view.
Don't you love it? Don't you love it when a plan comes together? I infiltrated Goldberg in every stadium around the country, every arena. Gene, you got to understand, it's been a plan. The whole plan was to exactly be next.
You know, you were unauthorized to be in any of those buildings. And as a matter of fact, you had not signed a contract with World Championship Wrestling. But things on Sunday, February the 21st, in the greater San Francisco Bay Area are going to be different. You've got a hard opponent, a man that was a great, great professional football player. And you're kind of a, I guess, a street guy, so to speak. Any kind of a game plan for Goldberg?
Well, it's going to be exactly what I did last Monday night when I had this jabroni come in the ring, saying he was the king of hardcore. Well, I proved him different. And I'm going to prove Goldberg different, because Goldberg, you can have me next, and you can have me next, and I'm going to take you piece by piece, little by little, and by the end, you will be mine.
You think you might be underestimating this guy that has had a phenomenal run. As a matter of fact, he took it up to 174-0 at the end of last year.
Well, you know what my daddy always says, Gene, the bigger you are, the harder you fall. The little you are, the farther you will fly.
All right, Bam Bam Bigelow is going to be colliding head-on with Goldberg. It's going to be part of Super Brawl 9, exclusively on pay-per-view, a match that a lot of people are anticipating, highly anticipating. Stay tuned, more exciting action after this.
This portion of WCW Saturday Night is brought to you by 1010321. Just dial it and save up to 50%.
Time on WCW Saturday Night. Making his way to the ring will be the self-proclaimed chairman of WCW, La Parka.
And he backs up that claim by bringing that steel chair to the ring. And Scott, as we've seen over the course of the past year or so, he's not afraid to use it.
Not at all. Not afraid to strut around and waste time either. But La Parka, the largest of the luchadors and arguably the toughest.
And he's going to need to use that size against the Beast from the East, 6'5", 350 pounds of Bam Bam Bigelow.
La Parka better get all the strutting in he can right here, because when the Beast, the tattooed head, the flame trunks, and the whole enchilada hits the ring, there's going to be no time for strutting.
You know, if you think back to when he first arrived on the scene in World Championship Wrestling, Bam Bam Bigelow was uninvited.
Yeah.
He did not have a WCW contract. But the one thing that you have to admit is that he never camouflaged his intentions.
No.
From the outset, from the first night at Nitro, Bam Bam Bigelow made it loud and clear that he wanted one man. He wanted Goldberg, and World Championship Wrestling has signed that match for Super Brawl, live on pay-per-view, coming up in 2 weeks and a day, February the 21st.
Well, let's not forget what went down on Nitro from the UTC Arena in Chattanooga, when Bigelow was escorted from the building by security and left on that little knoll just outside UTC, and he's chanting around, stomping amongst the fans, screaming for Goldberg, who came out but Goldberg, and they brawled in the grass up and down the knoll outside the UTC Arena. This time it will be inside the squared circle from Oakland, California at Super Brawl 9. Goldberg and Bam Bam one-on-one.
Well, one thing that we have come to realize since he debuted in September of 1997 is that Goldberg is not going to back down from a challenge from anyone. And he made that very clear this past Monday on Nitro when he said, who's next? Bam Bam Bigelow, you are next.
Little LaParca strut in the center of the ring, but I don't think you're going to play a lot of psychological games with a man like Bam Bam Bigelow, the former bounty hunter. Into the ropes. Oh, and he nailed LaParca with the clothesline. Oh, a little LaParca strut from Bam Bam.
Just ran right over LaParca, leveled him with the lariat, and then the mocking strut. Look at Bigelow, so intense here in the early going, walked right into the boot.
He certainly did, and walked into another one from LaParca. Still up, and a back elbow literally knocked LaParca for a loop.
Scott, I can't wait to see that exclusive footage this upcoming Monday on Nitro. You know, as we went off the air last Monday, we saw Hollywood Hogan and his Hollywood pal, Chuck Zito. They emerged from the limo. They had their sights set on David Flair, who they were stalking. And we saw backstage Ric Flair watching on a monitor. Nitro went off the air, but that was not the end of Ric Flair backstage. And we will have that exclusive footage this upcoming Monday on Nitro.
We are told the footage is extraordinary. Monday night from Buffalo on Nitro, you will see what went down after Nitro went off the air last Monday night. Ric Flair and Arn Anderson watching on the monitor as Chuck Zito and Hollywood Hogan stalked the 19-year-old son of the Nature Boy. They were helpless. They could only watch on the monitor. You're not going to believe what went down last Monday in Minneapolis after the show went off the air. You'll find out Monday on Nitro.
And that really illustrates what we've been talking about. This professional rivalry that has gone on for years between Hollywood Hogan and Ric Flair has turned into a personal vendetta to the point where, yes, Ric Flair is challenging Hogan for the world's heavyweight title at Super Brawl, but that is secondary to Flair. He just wants to get his hands on Hogan.
For 20-plus years, both men have transcended the great sport of professional wrestling to become anti-heroes amongst the American people. But who was the biggest name during the 1980s, during the 1990s? Was it Hogan? Was it Flair? It's an age-old debate that we may never settle, but we're going to try at Super Brawl 9, 2 weeks from tomorrow night, only on pay-per-view.
And I really think that Ric Flair put it best when he said, Hogan, you're putting your ego, your fame, and your notoriety on the line against my personal reputation.
Back in 1980, when Ric Flair won his first World Heavyweight Championship from Harley Race, no one would have thought that in 1999, Ric Flair would get a shot to become world champion for the 14th time. He gets it in 2 weeks at Super Bowl.
LaParca connects with the DDT, goes for the strut, and I think that was a mistake. He should have gotten on Bigelow immediately with a pinfall attempt. Instead, he showboated, and Bigelow is able to avoid the pin.
LaParca must be thinking that Bigelow is looking past him toward Goldberg at Super Bowl.
Oh,
that is a mega power slam from Bigelow.
The beast from the east roars. Picks up LaParca at the mask. Going to take him up for the greetings. Here we go. We're headed to the Garden State.
Oh! The greetings from Asbury Park. Not the Bruce Springsteen album, but the finishing maneuver of Bam Bam Bigelow. He's picking LaParca up one more time.
Yeah, Bigelow is out to prove that he's the real boss.
It's a two for one. Whoa!
You know, the first one is called Greetings from Asbury Park. The second one should be called Beatings from Asbury Park. Academic, the three count for Bam Bam Bigelow.
He is ready for Super Brawl and a one-on-one meeting with the Phenom in Goldberg. Look at this, giving LaParca a free ride to the dressing room is Bam Bam Bigelow. For Mike today, I'm Scott Hudson. We'll see you Monday night from Buffalo on Nitro.